Hi there. This is my review of the Laowa 90mm f2.8 CA Dreamer 2x magnification ultra macro lens. And for those of you who are familiar with this channel and my macro photography, you may well be saying to yourself, well, why do you need another 90mm lens? You've already got the Sony 90mm lens, which you've told us is pretty good. And that's true. So let's find out, why would I want this lens? And stay tuned because I'll be giving you a discount code a little bit later. So today I'm out testing this using my Sony A9 and the Quangren Twin Macro Flash, which is also available from Venus Optics, the makers of Laowa. So let's crack on. Okay, so first things first, I want to test out the 2x magnification of this lens and see how good it is. And I've come to this tree trunk. Now, tree trunks can be great places for the macro. It depends on the type of macro photography that you do. If it's documentary macro, it's really good because there are often loads of insects over tree trunks. If it's artistic, things are a little bit harder because it's difficult to get a nice clear background or some separation between the background because the insects and things are often on the actual tree trunk. So I'm going to spend some time here working away and see what I can find. I've had a look around the tree already. I've seen a couple of different types of spiders. I've seen ants crawling all over the tree. And ants are always really difficult with 1x magnification. So I probably, if I was using my Sony 90mm macro, I would have to put on some extension tubes to be able to photograph those ants. Otherwise, I'd end up having to crop down afterwards. So the ants might be a good opportunity for me. But the thing I'm most excited about here, there's a little larva that's trapped in a spider's web. And it's wriggling trying to get out. So I've already had a couple of shots at this and it's quite difficult. I'm going to have to keep working at it because the web is blowing around in the breeze a little bit and the larva is wriggling away trying to escape. But it's really tiny. I'm going to take a photo of it now and I'm just going to hold a key up against it. And I would say this key is maybe, 7mm across, something like that. So if I hold it next to the larva, the larva's probably only maybe 4 or 5mm across. I wouldn't even try to photograph this with my Sony 90mm macro, which is just 1x magnification. But let's see if I can get a shot of it. Oh wow, there you are. So hopefully you can see from that, it's a really tiny little larva. As I say, I think it's probably no more than 4 or 5mm across. But having a 2x magnification macro really does help to get these tiny little subjects. So I'm going to keep working away at this tree and let's see what I can come up with. So who is this lens for? Well, it's specifically designed for mirrorless cameras. So it's available in Canon RF mounts, Nikon Z mounts, Sony E mounts, and Leica L mounts. And it's great for anyone who wants to be able to push past 1-to-1 magnification for their macro work. There aren't many cameras out there from the traditional camera manufacturers who produce ultra macro lenses. Laowa is doing some really innovative things in this space, and that's the reason that I wanted to test it when Laowa reached out to me and asked me to do so. And some of those subjects that I photographed at that tree a few minutes ago wouldn't have been possible with my Sony 90mm lens. I'd have had to have put some extension tubes on it to try and focus a little bit closer, and even then it wouldn't have got me to full 2x magnification. So if you are interested in photographing smaller and smaller subjects, an ultra macro lens like this is the way to go. So let's push on now, and I'll talk about that lens a little bit more when I've tested it a little bit more. So this 2-to-1 magnification capability of this lens is really fun, and I want to carry on testing that, and I'm going to do that here at this pond. Now behind me there are some small bushes that have got leafhoppers on them. They're called rhododendron leafhoppers, and they're not native to the UK. I think they're from America, but they are beautiful little insects, and they're perfect for 2-to-1 magnification. But also around the pond there are some reeds, and we've got some damselflies on them. So I want to test this lens for its sharpness at different levels of magnification. So I'm going to take some shots of those damselflies in a not very traditional way. I'm not going to take a portrait shot focusing on the eyes. I'm going to pick out specific parts of their body, and potentially, luckily, hopefully, I might get some of them mating. So let's crack on with that. So let's talk specifications, and I'll stick the key specifications on the screen. But things that you need to know are that this is an entirely manual focusing lens. So if you're the type of photographer who likes to use autofocus for your macro, it's not going to work for you. It's entirely manual focus. It's all internal focus. The lens doesn't change in length as you focus, but it is manual. Now, I don't think that's a problem at all, because most macro photographers prefer to manually focus, but I know whenever I mention manual focus, there's always someone who says, well, I autofocus, and that's fine if you do, but you are in the minority. Most macro photographers do manual, and so this will work for the majority of people out there doing macro. So the available aperture range is from f2.8 to f22, which is absolutely fine. That's typical of most macro lenses. And you'll probably find, though, that at 2x magnification, you're not going to get anywhere near f2.8, because at that close focusing, the depth of field is absolutely shallow at f2.8. So you'll tend to find that you're probably working in the at least f5.6, if not f8 plus range. And that works absolutely great. I am finding, though, at f22, there's a little bit of fringing creeping in. But again, very rarely does anyone creep up to f22 in macro. But on the whole, that aperture range is working absolutely fine, and I'm getting some really lovely shots at the typical kind of apertures that I like to work at, that f8 to f13 range. So that's really good. Now, another thing is the working distance. So the working distance at 2x magnification is about 7 centimeters from the end of the lens. Now, that's just a little bit more than the length of the lens hood. So if you like to work with a lens hood, you might find that that lens hood gets in the way. It's pushing the foliage and things out of the way that you're trying to photograph the subject on. Now, I'm a person who likes to work with a lens hood for a variety of reasons, the main two being it keeps some dust off your front element, but also if you drop the lens, it's the lens hood that hits the ground, not the lens, and so you're not likely to get a stone or something that scratches the glass. Now, because the working distance is so close to that lens hood, I'm not using the lens hood at all. I've stopped using it. So it might be a problem for you if you like to use a lens hood. I also found that the first few times I put the lens hood on, it was a real struggle to get it on. It was really tight, but it seems to have loosened up as I've used it a little bit more throughout the day. So it might just have been that there was a little bit of sticky plastic or something in there that just needed sanding off or rounding off to make sure that it works, but you're probably not going to use that lens hood much at all. So let's talk about image quality. And I have to say, it's absolutely superb. You can get some really sharp images with this lens. Now, if you've never used an ultra macro lens before, it might take you a little bit of practice, but I'm used to this because I've also got the Laowa 25mm 2.5 to 5x magnification lens. But when I got that, that was a big learning curve to get used to, needing to be that precise for focusing. And so if you get this lens, you may need a good few hours practice to be able to get really sharp images. But once you've got that technique nailed, you will absolutely get sharp images. And I'm not seeing any issues with the sharpness, edge to edge, corner to corner. Everywhere throughout the frame looks pretty good to me. But probably one of the best parts of it is the out of focus areas. The bokeh is absolutely smooth. It's really, really nice. Part of that is because it's got 13 aperture blades. So it actually has more aperture blades than my Sony 90mm, which is an excellent lens. And it's the aperture blades that really help bring the smoothness to the bokeh. The more you have, the smoother the bokeh is. So in terms of image quality, I'm very impressed. And also colour rendering. I've only looked at the images on the back of my camera, but the colour rendering looks great too. So if I think there's any different, I'll put something in voiceover once I've looked at the images on my computer. But based on what I've seen so far, it's pretty good. So overall impressions of this Laowa 90mm 2x ultra macro lens. I have to say, it's really fun at this focal length to be able to get to 2x magnification. And in all honesty, this might be my new favourite macro lens. That Sony lens I have is absolutely superb, I've said that before. But in terms of image quality, I have to say, I think this is as good. But the fact that it gets you to 2x magnification means that this probably wins out. The only thing that that Sony lens has got that this doesn't is autofocus. Now, I never use autofocus for macro, but macro lenses do make superb portrait lenses too. And I only photograph people for fun, but I do take out that Sony 90mm when I'm out with friends and family taking photographs in those type of situations. So I might retire my Sony 90mm macro lens from my macro work and just keep that for fun. This could become my new macro workhorse. We'll have to see with time. But the lovely people at Venus Optics and Laowa have given you wonderful viewers of this channel a discount. So until the end of 2023, if you go to their website and buy using this code, you will get a 5% discount. If you're watching this video after the end of 2023, it's still a very good deal because this lens's recommended retail price is only $500. So it's probably about half the typical price of most macro lenses that are 90mm or in that sort of area. So either way, it's a great deal. So get out and get that whilst you've got that 5% off. Now, if you are interested in unusual lenses, another one that might be of interest to you is the Laowa 15mm ultra-wide macro lens, and I've reviewed that here. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.